Hey doll, so I am back. So this is going to be a video on this hair. I did a different kind of style, not just down, not just a side part, not just a middle part. So if y'all want to see where this hair is from and how I got this style, then keep on watching. Okay. Okay, doll, so this hair is from DSoar Hair. This is the box. Now, inside, the hair did come in this plastic bag. They also did send a pair of lashes as well. And then lastly, a bonnet. So they sent a bonnet. And also, I have my paper with all of my info on it as far as this wig. So this is a straight 5x5 HD lace closure wig, and it is 16 inches. My cap size is small. I always get small if companies offer it. This wig is shorter. I wanted to do like a different kind of length that I don't normally do, but I think it's super cute with this hairstyle for this length and everything. And I did like some little braids at the top, which you will see me actually do. And then this is the back. Also, if you're not the best braider like me, I definitely recommend to do it on a mannequin head. This makes it a lot easier. So I really like how it turned out. I think it's cute and different. Yeah, and it's a closure wig, so real easy peasy. Okay, if y'all want to see how to do this, then keep on watching. Okay, doll, so this is how the wig is looking. I already did the two braids on the side, so now I'm going to start working on the braids in the center. So I'm just going in and parting the hair, and then I'm going to go back and perfect the parts. This is a lot easier to do on your mannequin head versus doing it on your own head unless you are a really good braider. But if you could just braid a little bit like me, then definitely do it on your mannequin because it just makes it so much easier. So to make it easier to grab the hair and make sure that I'm not grabbing hair that is for the next braid, I'm just using my hot comb to kind of press that hair down and also press the hair up that's going to be for the braid that I'm about to do. And this just will make your parts a little bit more clean, and it just makes the braiding process a little bit easier because the hair is not going to be trying to pull over from the other side. So I'm just going in and doing a regular cornrow type of braid. So I'm just grabbing a section from the front and then sectioning off into three sections to start the braid, and then I will just keep going and grabbing hair as I go. It's kind of hard to explain if you don't know how to braid at all, but with some practice you definitely could probably do this on your own wig or even on someone else's head versus doing it if you already had the wig installed. So you can kind of just see what I'm doing. It's not the most clear shot where you can see me grabbing each strand of hair perfectly where you can really, really see it, but you can see what I'm doing, basically just grabbing hair and braiding and then grabbing more hair and braiding as I go down the whole braid. And then once I get to the end, I am actually going to braid it a bit longer than what I want because at the ends I am going to leave it a loose and just rubber band it in place and then curl the ends. So to make sure that the hair is braided all the way down to the end, you don't want to just stop at the end and put the rubber band on because the braid is going to start coming loose. So just braid it down a little bit further than what you actually want it to be because you can always just take this part loose. So once I braid it down a little bit further, I'm just going to grab a rubber band or elastic, whatever you want to use, and then just secure the braid into place so that it does not come loose. Really easy, not that hard to do if you can grasp how to braid, or if you already know how to braid, then you already know. But this is a cute little quick style to do, especially for a 5x5 closure. You have a larger space to work with, so it works out perfectly if you just want like a couple of little braids in the middle part. So I am also using the end of my rat tail comb to kind of just make the braids stretch out a little bit. I didn't want them to be super tight, so it will be a little bit more puffy and not super tight and neat, like kind of a little bit more messy looking. And before I start with the next braid, I also pull down some baby hairs in front of that section as well, and then I just go in and braid the next braid the same way that I did the first one. And once again, once I get to the end, I am going to braid it past that point and then also grab my elastic band or rubber band and just go ahead and put that into place so that the braid does not come loose. So now we have all of our braids. So I just did four in the center, which is a really cute little quick look. You can do smaller braids if you want more or whatever, or you could just do like two braids or whatever kind of style you want to do. So now I am grabbing my curling iron and just doing a curl on each part where I have braided the hair. So the pieces that are left out is what I'm curling right now. And I did already curl the rest of the hair on the wig, but I am going to go back in and curl a few pieces because I did want to add layers to this hair because I felt like it would just give it a lot more body and a cuter look. So I'm just grabbing this front section and I'm going to do some face framing layers, and I'm just using my shears to do so. Really easy. Anybody can do layers with a little bit of practice. It basically is just gliding the scissors down, cutting shorter at the top, and then working the scissors down and cutting where it's going to be layered longer towards the bottom and shorter towards the top. So after I have cut in a few layers around the front, I'm just going back in and curling those pieces so that the layered parts can really pop out. And I am also going to actually layer the little pieces that come out of the ponytails where the braids are, because I just wanted the hair to be really full and give like a really voluminous effect. So now you can see I'm working on the other side and I'm just curling those pieces as well, the little ponytails that are on the ends of the braids. Really simple. I wanted to kind of leave some extra clips in so y'all can see everything that I am doing. So after I have curled those parts, now I'm going in and doing the face framing layers on the other side of the wig and doing the same exact thing that I did on the other side. And this also will give your hair a more salon kind of look anytime that you do any kind of layering, because most wigs don't come layered, and if they do, that's more rare and the layers aren't really that precise. Like, it's just, you know, the closure is shorter or whatever, so it's just a little bit of layers, but doing this just really takes your hair to the next level. So you can see I've already layered the ponytails as well, and then I'm just fluffing the hair out and combing it out and everything like that. So for this wig, I did also decide that I did want to go ahead and tint my lace, which you will see me do in just a minute. I'm just playing around with the curls and everything to see what it's giving, and this is how the braids are looking in the front so far. So now I'm going to go ahead and take my wig off and just go ahead and tint the lace using my Eben New York Tinted Lace Spray. So I'm just going to spray a layer of this on and then I smooth it out to make sure that it's covering the full closure area. So after I do that, then I'm going to go ahead and put the wig on, line it up, and make sure that everything is looking how I want it to look. And of course, y'all know I like to cut off those little tabs that are on the sides before I start to lay anything down. First, I'm going to push my baby hairs back and make sure that they're not in the way whenever I start to lay the wig down. And then I'm just going to cut off those little tabs on each side, because they will kind of get in the way whenever you are laying your wig down. Like, it won't lay as good as it could if you went ahead and already cut these off. So after I cut them off, I am going to prep my skin. I cleaned it with some alcohol, and then I go in with a skin protectant. This one is by Walker, and this has been a lifesaver for me because my skin was having a bad reaction to any sprays or anything that I was using with lace. Okay, doll, so today I have a new product that I wanted to use, so I did want to talk through this part so I can show you what it is. So this is, I don't think it's really new. It's new to me, though. So this is the Eben New York Wonder Lace Bond, and this is an adhesive spray. One that I have is the Extreme Firm Hold Active, which is the red can, and it was $5.99 in my local beauty supply store. I believe I looked on Amazon, and it was like $15 or $10, something like that, but it's like way more on Amazon. So I'm going to be trying this today, and I also picked up their adhesive as well, since recently I did use my Ghost Bond. So I was like, let me try a different adhesive. So I may start venturing out and trying some, because my skin reacted well this time. I feel like I prepped it good and everything like that, so I might be starting to do me some adhesive sometime. Okay, so I'm gonna use this today. I've never used it before. Clean dry surface, spray the product 2 to 4 inches away from the hair onto the hairline or desired area. Allow it to dry until it's tacky and use a blow dryer on a cool setting. I think I'm just going to spray a layer on a little bit, and then this kind of like blast out, so be careful with this, y'all. So I think I'm gonna just kind of put a layer first and then blow dry it and then stick it down and then add more on top of it. By the way, this smells really good, actually. And I love Eben's products. Like, the lace tint that I used is by them as well. The color that I use is light warm brown. Because I know sometimes y'all ask. I need to get some more before I run out. But yes, Eben has a lot of really good products, especially for doing, like, lace wigs and stuff. So yes, this is also a 5x5, so I'm just going to blow dry it on cool, and I will use the edge of my rat tail comb to kind of hold the lace down in place. So while I allow this to really melt in place, I'm going to use my elastic band. I'm just going to tie this on and let it continue to melt and dry. Ooh. Okay. Y'all, this spray is up and it's stuck. It's kind of giving like adhesive vibes. Let's see. Like, it's kind of like grabbing tight to my skin for me to even. Okay. All right, so it looks pretty good. Of course, you can see there where it's like extra spray and stuff, and I have to seal the edge back down. So I'm gonna take some alcohol and just clean off any excess that is further down. You can already see that line kind of going away. It looks really good. Like, this spray is bomb. Like, I can already tell I'm gonna love this spray, and it's like really giving a tacky glue effect versus just like how a hairspray normally is. Like, it's definitely giving more of a glue effect. Like, I can't really explain it, but yeah, I'm gonna spray again, just try to get the edges real good. It's like you don't want to spray it too far back, because then you probably will really get it everywhere, but the way that it sprays out is kind of aggressive. So you still have to kind of be careful with it. Okay, so I'm just gonna kind of clean it and then blow dry. It looks really good, like, so far. Okay, so if y'all like to do the comb method like I like to normally do, like hold the comb down and let the lace kind of press into the skin, this is really sticky. It gives like a glue kind of effect, so that doesn't work the best to do that with this application. So probably just use your elastic band. But yeah, I'm gonna just pull my baby hairs back down and then I'll put my elastic band back on so this can melt into place. Okay, so now that our wig is laid and everything like that, now I'm just tying my elastic band back on and letting that sit for a minute, and then now I have removed it and you can see how good the melt is. This spray is really, really bomb, so I'm definitely going to be using it on a lot of upcoming installs and things like that. So I am going to go in and start cutting down my baby hairs and just kind of trimming them because they are too long to start off with and that's just not going to work. And then I'm going to start laying my baby hairs. I played around with my baby hairs to see what I wanted to do. I kind of wanted to do like some dramatic baby hairs with swirls, but I had somewhere to go and I didn't want to give that kind of look. So I tried to do it a little bit more classy, but I still wanted that swoop in the middle where they are still a little bit more dramatic, but not so much where it has all of those different, you know, twists and turns to it, okay? So this is how the baby hairs are looking, and then I'm just combing the hair down. I did go back in and play with my baby hairs a little bit more, so they will look kind of different in the intro and outro portion, but this is what the hair is giving. Like, it's looking real cute. It's giving scapiana, even though it's just a closure. It's not even a frontal, okay? And the hair is giving body yaddy, and it looks very natural because it is a shorter length hair. So super cute. And then I'm going to move on to making the parts really, really pop out, and this definitely does help to define it even more, and it's going to look even more realistic. So don't forget to do this step. I'm just using some of my MAC face powder, which is a foundation powder that matches my skin tone, and I'm just applying it in the parting area, anywhere where it's supposed to be scalp showing, if you know what I'm saying. So this is also going to conceal any knots that didn't bleach properly, and it's just going to give overall a really nice scalp effect. And then I'm also going to take my wrapping mousse once again and just place that everywhere where I have put powder, because we want to melt the powder into place. We don't want it to give an ashy vibe. So I'm just going to put that down everywhere, and then I'm going to blow dry it to just speed the process up. And this did not mess up my braids or my baby hairs or anything like that. The spray is really tacky that I used to lay the wig, so the baby hairs pretty much stayed in place really good. And this is what it's giving, okay? Stay tuned for the outro. Okay, doll, so this is the completed look of the hair. I think it turned out super cute. And yes, I love DSoar hair. I've been working with them for a long time, so definitely check them out. I want to show you guys a quick outfit. I didn't put my shoes on yet though. Really quickly, this is the outfit. It's just this cute little, bless you. Okay, so really quick for the outfit, it's just this really cute little plaid peplum top, and then I have on these jeans that are like a bluish color, which match pretty perfectly with the top. And then I'm gonna wear it with my pink bag, just to tie the pink in more. And also, I did want to say you can add like some butterfly clips or something on the ends, but I didn't put any, so yeah, I'm just gonna wear it as is. J. Rossi made the beat.